Hey guys, welcome to our channel. My name is Andrea with Foodimentary Adventures in Food. And I am here today because I am participating in a special egg roll in a bowl collaboration hosted by Corey of Cooking with Corey. So there are a couple of other ladies that are participating in the collaboration as well. But first, let me tell you a little bit about Corey. So he is a self-described former chef turned meat cutter, and his cooking videos are absolutely amazing, restaurant quality type recipes that are easy enough for the home cook to tackle. The next person participating in the collaboration is Alicia from Alicia Lynn, and she does lots of recipes and shopping hauls and also a little bit of travel as well. The next person participating in the collaboration is Holly from Hey Mom, What's for Supper. She has the best dinner videos. They're simple but delicious, ideas that I've never thought of doing before. And I love the fact that she always mixes in a little bit of humor in her videos as well. So today I'm going to make a Korean-inspired egg roll in a bowl. Out of all the different types of Asian flavors, Korean is probably my favorite. So this is going to be an egg roll in a bowl with a little bit of kick. So let me show you what you're going to need.
So you are going to need some coleslaw mix. You are going to need some soy sauce and fish sauce. You're gonna need some sugar or honey, some Serrano chili peppers, and also some garlic. I am using just a medium red onion. I really wanted to use shallots, but the shallots did not look good at all at my grocery store. So you can use a medium onion or you can use a few shallots. You're going to need some gochujang, and you can find this in the Asian section of your grocery store. And it's, you know, pretty much available everywhere, so you shouldn't have a problem finding it. And then you're also going to need some fresh ground pork. So let's get started.
So I have my pan on a medium heat, and I am going to add in my onions and my garlic and serrano peppers. And I'm just gonna let this cook for just a minute or two. So my onions have been cooking for about 3 minutes. They're not all the way tender, but that's okay. That's how I want them to be. I'm gonna add in my ground pork. And I am going to cook my ground pork all the way through. All right guys, so my pork is completely cooked, and what I did is I turned it up on high heat, as high as it would go, because I wanted it to get those caramelized bits of pork, as you can see in here, and the onion is also caramelized a bit too. That is what I was looking for. So next I'm going to add in my coleslaw mix, and it has a really good flavor from the chilies and from the onions. Even though I haven't added in any seasonings just yet, it's very flavorful. Okay. So I've added in my coleslaw mix, and I am just going to let this wilt down probably for a minute or two. You can see that my cabbage has wilted down. Now I'm going to add in my sugar, my soy sauce and fish sauce, and my gochujang. I probably have a heaping teaspoon of the chili paste, so whatever is your personal preference is how much you're going to add. So I've turned up my heat back on to a high heat, and I am just going to let this stir fry, and then I will come back and show you the finished product. All right guys, so here is the finished product, and it is so tasty. I love the fact that with this recipe, you can adjust the spice level. So if you want
More gochujang, definitely add it in. If it's not salty enough, add some more soy sauce or some more fish sauce. But it is so simple and so delicious. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please make sure to give us a thumbs up. If you have not subscribed to our channel, we'd definitely love to have you. And make sure you check out Corey's video, Holly's video, and Alicia's video. I'll make sure to link their YouTube channels in my description box. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.